Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Duke Blue Devils Dynasty here in NCAA Football 14. Now, we started off the season, I believe, 2-0, and we've fallen on hard times, losing four straight since then. But today we take on 3-3 Virginia. It'll be a road game, but maybe we've got a shot to get back in the win column today. We'll have to see how this thing goes, but we'll have to play a strong road game to get it done. Obviously, confidence not riding high right now for the Blue Devils, but hoping to turn things around today. So here we go with the first possession. Cirk wants to throw when he will. Barnes makes the catch, and it's going to be 3rd and 2 there after the 5-yard reception. Bring in the fullback and run this football. Wilson's going to get 4 yards and a first down. 2nd and 8. Now Cirk drops back, throws over the middle, and it's Max McCaffrey making the catch. And he's going to get 7 yards, making it 3rd and short again. Can we convert again? Here is Shaq Powell going to get the first down. So the Blue Devils moving the chains here in the first quarter. Play action here for Cirk, and he's got nowhere to go. He's swallowed whole there, and there's the first sack for Virginia of the game. 2nd and 17. Next play, and it's the second sack of the game. Just like that, bringing pressure and getting there. It's 3rd and forever now, 3rd and 24. Cirk throws this one-on-one, and he has his hands on it, but he will not be able to catch it. That is going to be time to punt for the Blue Devils. So Virginia gets the football now, 1st and 10. Hand off on the draw, and there's some room for him on the left-hand side. Darting in and out of defenders, and he could be gone. 20, 10, touchdown, Virginia. First play from scrimmage, and just like that, 71 yards to pay dirt. That is not what you want to see out of your defense right off the bat in a game, but yet that's what happened. Big time play, and Virginia's up 7-0 on the board first, as you see. The scamper all the way to the end zone. Diving effort there was not going to stop him. So Duke already at a disadvantage here in the first quarter, despite moving the ball a little bit on their first drive. 2nd and 8 now, and Cirk is trying to escape, and he can't. He's sacked again, losing 11 yards there. That's not good at all. 3rd and 19, trying to stand in there and deliver a throw, and he does. He finds Nash. His tight end, Anthony Nash, makes the catch, 30 yards, and they convert on 3rd and long. Okay, they'll take that. Here you see the replay right down the middle of the field, and he's open and makes the catch. Cirk able to get him the football and relieve a little pressure on this Duke offense here, as they are at least in Virginia territory, going over the middle again, and that's a misfire right there. It's going to be 4th down. Cirk not very accurate on that play. So Virginia gets the football back. They've got a 3rd and 11. And here is a throw right down the middle of the field. Oh, my goodness. All right. I did use her at the end of that play, but not until he ran right past the receiver. Look at this. He's just continuing downfield. And then by the time I took control of him, it was too late. There's just no recognition there on the play by the defender. That's a little frustrating. 3rd and long, we couldn't get him off the field. This 3rd down we do, though. We sniff out that screen pass, and it's incomplete. So 4th and 5, and a long field goal attempt is up, and it is good, and it's got plenty of leg. My goodness. Dealing with a big-time kicker right there. Virginia up 10-0 here in the second quarter. Cirk rolling to the right, and he's going to run. He is able to get a 1st down before going out of bounds. Gain of 12. And Thomas Cirk is able to get the Blue Devils that 1st down. So a handoff here to Sean Wilson. He gets 6 yards. It'll be 3rd and inches eventually. And Shaq Powell gets the call. He barrels forward for a 1st down. And we are now at midfield. Cirk on 1st and 10. Throwing. Finds his man Reeves. Makes the catch for 16-yard gain. And the Blue Devils now gaining a little momentum once again on the offensive side. They need to go down here and punch one in and get right back in this ballgame. Handoff. Wilson is going to try the left side, and he has got 7 yards again. 2nd and 3. Like to be in these shorter yardage 2nd and 3rd downs, and it pays off there with another Sean Wilson run for 8 yards this time. And a 1st down. Here we go. 2nd and 5 now. Cirk rolling to the right. Is he going to run? No, he's going to throw. Finds his man. That's Baylinson. He reaches forward and does get a 1st down. It's going to be 1st and goal. Duke on 1st down. They choose to hand off to Sean Wilson. He is going to get towards the goal line, and he is in. He punches it in for the score. Sean Wilson will not be denied at the goal line. Duke scores their first points of the day. As you see right there, that tackle was not going to bring him down before he got into the end zone. So here is a screen pass now for Virginia, 3rd and 6. Fighting for that first down, fighting very hard actually, but he will be just inches short. They have to punt. So Duke gets the football right back, having scored on their last possession, feeling pretty good about things, getting a first down right there. Cirque out of the shotgun, 3rd and 11, finds this man. That's going to be a catch, and a big third down conversion. Lee makes the catch. 3rd and 21, however, and can they do it again? No, he's going to be held short. 4th and 4, they're going to attempt a field goal here with just seconds left in the half to tie the game. The kick is wide right, no good. Duke does not tie up the ball game going into half, as this field goal, it had the distance, but it was wide right. So 10-7 is your halftime score. Duke hanging in there after giving up the first 10 points to Virginia. Come back and get a score and put themselves right in this. Virginia gets the football to start the second half. Play action. Nice little throw right there over the defender's head, and they've got a first down on that first down play. Johns wants to throw. He's got all sorts of time. He just kind of maneuvers around the pocket and then finds his man for a 13-yard gain. Virginia moving the football again. 2nd and 4. There is the draw play that got him the touchdown early on. This time it gets him a first down and a 4-yard run. Okay, here's Johns dropping back on 1st and 10. Going to the goal line, and it's caught, and he's in for a touchdown. Boy, oh boy, driving right down the field again and finding their way in the end zone, extending that lead back to 10 points. Well, assuming they get their extra point, it'll be 17-7 here in the third quarter. Duke had no answer defensively on that drive, so back to their offense now. Cirque on 2nd and 5, finds Baylinson. Baylinson is going to fall forward for a first down and a gain of 7. All right, 2nd and 7 now. Cirque dropping back. Took the snap under center. Oh, trying to get away. He does get away, and he gets himself a first down. Looked like it might be another sack coming up, but instead, Cirque scrambles and gets the first down. 2nd and 8 now, throwing to Baylinson. Again, across the middle of the field. He kind of falls backwards into a first down, and Duke is moving the football again. On Virginia's side of the field, 3rd and 10. That catch is made by Lee. Lee fights hard, and I think he got it. First down on the 11-yard catch. Okay, this is working out well. Sean Wilson to the left. Gonna run, spin, and get 8 yards. Duke looking to get in that end zone and make it a 3-point game again. Wilson. He's gonna get injured right there. It's 3rd and inches, but bigger problem is Wilson's off the field now. Shaq Powell in to get that first down, and he's bruising forward. Looking for contact. They got 1st and 10. Cirque throwing. Thought he had his man there. Oh, it's picked off. Picked off at the 5-yard line by Virginia. Going the other way. Yeah, he just didn't lead him far enough towards the corner of the end zone, I guess. And it was jumped right there, the route, by the defender. Bad turnover right there as they were getting right down there to get points again. Cirque doesn't want to hear the criticism, but here you go. You've got an injury to Shaq Powell now. First it was Wilson. Now it's Powell. Yeah, we're running out of running backs here. Hopefully Wilson comes back. Here is a gain and a first down by Virginia. They're moving the football again. 13 more yards there as Mizell goes over 100 yards now on the day. Johns wants to throw to the end zone. One-on-one. Could have been a pick right there, but he can't hang on to it. And he's beside himself that he didn't make the play. They really needed a turnover right there. 3rd and 7. John's throwing to the sideline, and they can't tackle him in time. He's got a first down for Virginia. They move this back 2nd and 15 now. I believe they had a sack, but here's a successful run. It is finally stopped at about the 2-yard line. So here you go with a 3rd and 1 play. Johns, we're bringing some pressure, but he hangs in there and he finds his man in the back line of the end zone. Severin makes the catch. It's Johns' 2nd touchdown pass of the day. And Virginia now in a commanding lead, 24-7, with under 3 minutes to play. Last gasp of air for the Duke offense. 4th and 18, throwing and way overthrowing his man. That is going to be a turnover on downs. And that is effectively going to end the ball game. Duke cannot respond in this second half, and they go down again. Their 5th straight loss. They're now 2-5 on the season. Virginia now has a winning record at 4-3. Mizell, your player of the game. Yeah, he did some work there with 135 yards rushing and a long touchdown that set the pace. So Sirk cannot get it done today. Gets sacked 6 times in the loss. Kind of a painful day right there. Wilson gets 57 yards. Man, we just can't get the running game going to the point we'd really like to. Obviously, both these guys contributing, but we need better numbers than that. You see the receiving core here and what they're able to do. But again, it does not add up to a victory as they are taking their lumps in ACC play. We turn to the recruiting. The recruiting in NCAA 14. If anybody knows me, they know I do not like this system, but trying to do what we can. At least we're leading with the 79 overall D end. Otherwise, things look kind of grim for us. We did get a punter and a kicker committed, but we need some talent on this team coming in. And I don't know. I don't see it coming right now. These guys are not very high overalls, and we're not even leading on half of them. And I don't know. I'm not sure how bright the future looks here. Sometimes you take your lumps in a season and you go, yeah, but we got a big recruiting class coming in. Turn things around and change the atmosphere here. We're not seeing that yet as we're having our struggles in the recruiting. But I don't know. Maybe some of these guys will turn out to really be valuable to the team. It's hard to say here, but we need guys with higher overalls, definitely. I know we're just kind of getting started here with the program. Pops Patterson taking over, but he needs to make some inroads in recruiting and do it fast here so we can see some improvement on the field. Next up is number 25, Virginia Tech at 5-2. This could be painful, guys. Oh, boy. Come on back for more Duke football. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!